Hey, welcome back to another episode of the Creative Breakthrough Podcast. I'm your host, Shereen Kassam. If you're a new listener, thank you so much for joining us. If you're a repeat listener, I can't tell you how grateful I am that you guys come back week after week after week. I know right now is a very anxious time. I know we're very, a lot of us are not sure what's happening in the world and where we're going, and there's a lot of distress and there's a lot of anxiety. And if you're listening to this podcast in the future, it is March 2020 right now, and we are going through the global epidemic called COVID-19. And I'll just give you a quick update on what's going on here. I'm based in Orlando, Florida, in the United States. It is not being taken as seriously as I would like here. If you've seen the pictures, there's people on the beaches. Nobody is staying at home. I mean, I don't want to say nobody. I'm staying at home, but a majority of people just do not seem to understand the severity of this. And so I'm urging you that no matter where you are in the world right now, whether it has hit you guys hard, whether you're in Italy or Spain, where it's like it's become a big deal and you guys are under lock and key, a police mandate to stay inside, versus if you're in Florida and nobody's mandating you to stay inside, just stay inside. I don't understand why this is so hard for people. Like, we actually get to stay inside. Nobody's asking us to go fight a war. Nobody's asking us to go learn how to shoot a gun or go fight for our own food. This is not the Hunger Games. All they're saying to you is stay at home. And I don't know why that's so hard. There's so much to do at home. There's so much to read. There's so much to learn. There's so much TV to watch. There's instruments to learn how to play. Like, just stay at home. It's not going to be for the rest of your life. And for those of you who are like, well, I'm not going to get sick because I'm healthy or I'm young. Yeah, well, you don't know that, right? Like, there's more and more research and data coming out every day that's saying that that's not a true statistic, and that there are young people getting sick. So I am going to plead with you. Please, please, please just stay at home, self-isolate, quarantine yourself, and find something to do. Like, write a book, write a poem, blog, create a vlog, learn how to edit movies, learn how to edit TV, start your own podcast. And I am willing to sit here and talk to you guys about that. So if you want to start a podcast and you don't know how to start a podcast, let me know. Hit me up and I will walk you through how to start a podcast, okay? Like, I will do what I need to do to play my part to make sure you guys stay at home and you guys stay safe. I'd love to hear what's going on where you guys are from. I know we've got listeners all over the world, from Kenya, Zimbabwe, Kuwait, Malaysia, Czech Republic, United Kingdom, Australia, Canada, United States. There's more countries that I'm missing. I would love to know how you guys are dealing with the coronavirus and what you guys are doing to stay busy. So hit me up. Email is hi@funnybrowngirl.com. I will say, one of the hardest things about going through what we're going through right now is that I have been super anxious. I find that I'm not super anxious about dying, or, I mean, and that's really like far left field. I'm super anxious just about what's happening in the world. And just watching is that this virus is just taking anybody and everybody. Like, it's not taking people based on race, religion, income levels, but yet we're still divided on all of those things. Like, in the United States, we're still divided, Republicans and Democrats. We're still divided between the rich and the poor, who gets tested, who doesn't get tested, who doesn't have money to pay rent next month, and who does have money to pay rent next month, who's hoarding all the groceries, who's not hoarding all the groceries. Like, we're still so divided, and we're not learning from this epidemic that we need to work together. And that's just making me so anxious. Also, what's making me anxious is, as a creative in the gig economy, I don't know when I'm going to get my next paycheck. I don't know how I'm going to make rent next month. I don't know when I'm going to get to work again or take the stage again. Or even if I ever will, like, will all the comedy clubs shut down because they can't stay in business? Or will there be conferences, and when will the next conference happen? Because, like, a lot of conferences got canceled, and it takes a lot of money and time to rebuild those and put those back together. And within 48 hours last weekend, when all of this stuff started to come to a fold, to fruition in the United States, within 48 hours, I lost $5,000 worth of gigs and of conferences and comedy shows. And so I've been super anxious, and it's definitely hindered my day-to-day life, because I'm not sure, like, what I should be doing. Like, I'm not sure how I should be moving forward with my life. And I can understand if a lot of you guys are in the same place, especially if you have families to feed and your children are home and you're trying to work and teach at the same time. It's been rough. And so today what I want to share with you are just some things that I have been doing to try to stay focused and and work on my anxiety. So the one thing that I have been doing, I started doing it today, is setting a schedule for myself. I set an alarm clock for the first time. I woke up at 8 o'clock. I set a schedule. I said, this is what I'm going to do before lunch. This is what I'm going to do after lunch. This is what I'm going to eat. I think my eating habits have become really out of whack. So focusing on making sure that I'm planning out my eating so that I'm not mindlessly snacking. I put my workouts in there because I need to work out. Like, just because I'm sitting at home all day doesn't mean that I should not have to work out. And I'm lucky that I'm in Florida, and because we are not on a self-quarantine yet, we are not in a lockdown yet, I am allowed to go outside. And so while I am allowed to go outside, I want to make sure that I am taking advantage of that. I am being super careful though. This really annoys me is like when I'm walking and somebody tries to pass me, I'm like, whoa, 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 like social distancing. Like, can you not take your 6 steps away from me and pass me? So I'm being very conscious about that as well. But I'm also using the time to really take care of myself. Being alone, self-quarantined, I realized that I'd stopped caring a lot about what was happening on the inside of me in terms of my emotional health and my mental health. And so I've been doing a lot of journaling. And I will say I hate journaling. Journaling is not my thing. Like, I do not wake up in the morning and do my day pages or whatever they're called, where you're supposed to like free write for 3 minutes straight and just release everything from your brain. I don't do that. But what I have started doing is turning on the recorder on my phone in the morning and just for 3 minutes talking about what's going on, what's happening, what am I thinking about, where's my head at. And then throughout the day, if I feel like I'm getting anxious again, I'm doing the same exercise for 2 or 3 minutes. And I think it's super important, especially during this time, to write about this experience, to write about how you're feeling, about what you're going through, what is happening around you, because like we're not gonna go through this situation again, right? And if you're a creative, you're a poet, you're an artist, you're a singer, this is all stuff that you can use. This is all stuff that you can pull from. And maybe right now you're not feeling the most creative because you are anxious or you are stressed financially, or you're trying to balance being creative and having your kids at home or your spouse at home. And so I definitely suggest writing about this experience. It's also a really great exercise because at the end of this experience, we should all come out of this as different people. We should all come out of this with a better understanding of the world. And if you don't come out of this with a better understanding of the world, then you didn't get what you needed out of this experience. And I think that's why it's super important to journal, because that way you'll be able to see, maybe it'll be a small change in how you interact with people or how you treat the environment, but you'll be able to see some sort of change in how, just not only in yourself emotionally, mentally, but also maybe even just your viewpoints about people and your viewpoints about class diversity and socioeconomic issues and financial issues and even politics. Like, now is the time to like really understand what's happening in the world. Like, why are we so divided in a time when we should all be coming together? We're still divided. We're still fighting about toilet paper. It makes no sense whatsoever. And so release those emotions and talk about them. Use this time also to like learn a new skill set, educate yourself, figure out like how can you learn a new skill. I'm definitely trying to do that. My goal for this sort of self-isolation until I can get work again is, one, figure out what is another source of income that I can work on, and two, I really want to write a one-woman show. And that's like my goal, is how do I write a one-woman show? What does it take to put one on? How do you structure it? It's like a whole new creative outlet that I've never experienced or never played with. And so, first of all, if any of you listening have any experience doing a one-woman show, feel free to hit me up. I would love to talk to you. But again, if you're looking for classes to take or opportunities, or you have a class and you want people to know about it, feel free to hit up the Facebook group, funnybrowngirl.com/Facebook, or go to facebook.com and search Creative Breakthrough Community. And there's people there who have listed classes. Like, one woman is teaching guitar classes. Another one has listed a free site to take some classes online or learn a language. So definitely do that. Now is also a time, If you are financially set and you are just bored and you're just sitting at home binge watching TV, now is the time to be creative. Now is the time to think of ways to set a new norm. So for example, there's a DJ called DJ D Nice. And if you haven't heard of him on Instagram, it's at D Nice, D-N-I-C-E. He held an 8-hour DJ party. He went on Instagram stories, went live on Instagram for 8 hours and just DJed. He spun records and he had like celebrities come in and like just party with him, like Michelle Obama and Mariah Carey and tons of others. And that's, and he created a new model, and he went from like 200,000 Instagram followers to over 1 million, and people were sharing his Cash App and paying him money for this. And like, there's a way to make income during all of this. So be creative and like in terms of how can you change the norm of your creativity, of your field, of your industry. There's a couple of comedians in LA who have gotten together and have decided to do a comedy show, and they're going to only sell 100 tickets at $5 a piece, and that's how they're going to try to pay their rent this month. And then there's people who are just posting things on Instagram and Twitter and Facebook randomly, and because there's so many eyes on social media right now that if you have something to say, or if you have something to be seen, now is the time to put it on there. And there's a guy, he's the guy who taught me what stand-up comedy is in Boston. His name is Dana J. Bean. And he last week wrote a song called the Coronavirus Rhapsody, based on the Bohemian Rhapsody song by Queen. And he just threw it up on Twitter, and it has gone viral. I mean, it is being shared across the world, from South Africa to Australia to the United States. He's been featured in magazines, podcasts, Newsweek. I mean, just, and he talks about this, and he literally said, he's like, anytime I would post something on Twitter, I would like reminisce over it. I would review it and review it and review it and think, is it perfect? Is it good enough to be posted on Twitter? And he would go through this agonizing process of posting things on Twitter. And when he wrote this song last week, it was on a whim. He said he took him 7 minutes to write, and he just threw it up on Twitter. He didn't even like second guess himself, and that went viral. And so don't second guess yourself. Just throw stuff out there. Of course, like, manage your brand. Like, don't be posting things that you're going to regret. But yeah, now is your time. Now is the time to go learn a new skill set. Now is the time to be creative online, to put that stuff out there. Now is the time to really document how you're feeling and look inside of you and take care of yourself. Self-care right now is so important. And I realize that. It's only been a week, and I've already realized how important my self-care is. It's important for me to breathe. I've been trying to meditate. And we can go over a quick meditation exercise if you want. I've been learning how to just take time for myself and be with my thoughts and just slow down a little bit and understand like what's happening within me, because we're always so busy. We're always go, go, go. And then when we're stuck at home by ourselves, that's when our minds start to race. And so trying to figure out, okay, like, what is it that's bothering me? And what is it that I need to be working on? It's taking time for myself now that I'm not being pulled in so many different directions. It's taking that time to say, okay, I can now read this book, and I can take a bath, and I can just sit here with my eyes closed for a hot minute. And so really just use this time, because we may never get this opportunity again to just be alone or just be without distractions in our life. And so use this time, whether you are being a creative right now, or whether you're too anxious to be a creative, or whether you've got a lot of stress on your hands, or whether you're teaching your children, find that time to really look inside yourself and understand, what can you get out of this experience? And you may not understand that until the experience is over, but at least document how you're feeling so that you have something to pull from at a later time. Okay, I'm going to wrap up real quick. I just want to also say thank you to everyone who donated towards podcasting equipment for myself. As some of you may have heard, I was using podcasting equipment, and then the person who gave it to me decided all of a sudden he wanted it back, so he took it back, and now I have no podcasting equipment. So I've been raising money from donations. So people who usually get a Starbucks coffee every day or order out lunch, now that you might have that disposable income because you can't go out and get that coffee every day, would love it if you could donate that to me. And it's a really simple way. You can use your credit card or PayPal and go to, it's ko-fi.com/funnybrowngirl. Again, that's ko-fi.com/funnybrowngirl. If you donate $20, I will be more than happy to get on a 30-minute Skype call with you, or Google Hangouts, or even over email if you don't want to talk to me. And we can go over any creative questions or coaching you may have, and I will sit there and talk to you and help you kind of figure out your game plan. So super easy thing to do, and would love to chat with you. Okay. This week we have a super, super special guest. This guy, I owe him a lot about my career. I owe him so much. I mean, he gave me my first real break in comedy, and so I can't thank him enough. And his name is Jeff Friday, and he's the founder of the American Black Film Festival. I had the opportunity in 2017 to take part in the HBO Comedy Wings competition, and since then, I have been a huge advocate for American Black Comedy Festival. I think everybody who is a creative, whether you're African American or not, should attend this festival, should participate in this festival, and should be involved in this festival. Who is Jeff Friday? For those of you who don't know, words cannot describe him, but here is what he said he is, or sent me as his bio. Jeff Friday is one of the most innovative entrepreneurs in the film and television industry today. A successful producer, festival founder, film financier, champion of diversity, and mentor to many, Friday has established a unique legacy in Hollywood, generating a tremendous amount of goodwill within the creative and corporate communities. Jeff Friday currently serves as CEO of ABFF Ventures, LLC, a multifaceted company specializing in the production of live events, television, and film focused on African American culture. So, what are we waiting for? Let's get started.